cross-border violence continues to escalate between Israel and Palestine. Israel pounded Gaza for a fifth day with land and air attacks on Hamas fighters. Rockets were also fired from Gaza in retaliation. Israel's military chief has said that its airstrikes on Gaza had struck a significant blow against the weapons production capabilities of Hamas and other militant groups, and it would take the militants a long time to rebuild them.
אנחנו תוקפים בעוצמה רבה שכוללת הישגים רבים שהובילו לפגיעה משמעותית מאוד במערך הייצור של חמאס וגאפ באמצעי לחימה שייקח הרבה מאוד זמן.
As violence continued for the fifth day, Jewish and Arab mobs again clashed in the town of Lod on Friday. A Jewish man was shot and seriously wounded in the Israeli city on Friday, and the situation is worsening even after the deployment of additional security forces in the city. Now, in the Tel Aviv neighborhood of Jaffa, an Israeli soldier was attacked by a group of Arabs, thus further instigating the fire. Meanwhile, in the West Bank city of Hebron, seven Palestinians have been killed in a day of clashes between protesters and Israeli forces. The intensification of the conflict has now claimed over 130 Palestinian lives in Gaza, amid fears that the ongoing conflict may lead to a full-blown war. International pressure is mounting on Israel and Palestine to de-escalate and to exercise restraint. The Deputy Assistant Secretary for Israel and Palestinian Affairs, Hadi Amer, has landed in Israel to try to calm Israel and Palestinians' most intense hostilities in years. Now, the Biden administration has reiterated working towards de-escalation of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict and restoration of peace in the volatile region. The UAE has also called on the Israeli government and Hamas to commit to a ceasefire to stem the violence. Bahraini Foreign Minister Abdul Latif bin Rashid Al Zayani held a phone call with the Palestinian Foreign Affairs Minister to discuss the crisis. Now, interestingly, both the nations normalized their diplomatic ties with Israel last year as a part of the US brokered Abraham Accords. However, this did not stop them from condemning the recent violence in the region. Now, earlier, our chief executive editor, Balkishan Opadie, spoke with Paul Hirschson, who is the spokesperson of the Israeli Foreign Ministry. Listen in if he thinks the conflict could impact the newly improved ties with the neighboring Arab nations.
WION, now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.